welcome to the Maserati Trofeo from Shanghai in China. Three races then, and there's the possibility for Mauro Calamia, who's on pole for all three races, to become the new champion. We're on board here with Alberto Cola. He's on the second row of the grid behind Alan Simoni, Riccardo Ragazzi and Mauro Calamia. Start of the race then, and lap one. Three races on the program. Calamia, the 35, Ragazzi, the 29, Simoni, 23, 51 is Cola. A phalanx of local racers here as well. This is the penultimate round of the season. And Calamia, well, going a bit off track there. Calamia still leading from Riccardo Ragazzi. The last round of the season will be at Abu Dhabi, but Calamia would love to go to the United Arab Emirates with the championship crown already in his back pocket. Alan Simoni is third, and those three starting to pull away, even though we're only about halfway through the first lap here in Shanghai. With a bit of an attack on Mauro Calamia. This is the big straight at the Shanghai International Circuit, more than a kilometre long. It offers a lot of possibilities for attack and for overtaking, and Ragazzi is determined to take advantage of those opportunities, although Calamia manages to close the door. Ragazzi stays second, with Simoni third. We're not doing the full circuit that the F1 racers do when they're here. So Calamia leading at the end of the first lap, which we saw in full. You see there a problem for one of the Chinese drivers here. That's the number 16, that's Bo Song. The battle for first still raging. It's still Calamia from Ragazzi, from Simoni. And it's Cola who is in fourth, a bit out on his own there. Well, Ragazzi now has his hands full with Simoni. And with this Ragazzi-Simoni battle going on, it has allowed Calamia to open up an advantage of a few car lengths at the front. Unrelenting. The competition here between the leading trio. The first two races, half-hour races. The third is an hour-long race with a compulsory pit stop and a driver change if you're competing as a team. The position's stable here. Cola isolated in fourth. And behind them, I think it's Giorgio Senagiotto, and Giuseppe Fasciolo is in the leading six as well. And on the long straight, no one managing to make anything stick. It's a sprint race for half an hour, no pit stop here in race one. for Kalamya. It's all about avoiding driver error here. He looks very well set to go on and claim his sixth win of the season. So the Swiss driver still leading. Let's go on board then with Alberto Cola in fourth place. Cola making a return to the Maserati Trofeo after skipping the trip to the United States. Technical through the first part of the circuit here at Shanghai. Cola getting the good racing lines and trying to lose as little time as possible. The 60, it's Roberto Ranieri managing to get going again. Well, we can see what happened here. I think he just went into a spin here, losing control. But as we saw, Roberto Ranieri did get going again. Up front, it's still Kalamya, then Ragazzi, then Simoni. Kalamya of the Swiss team must be a couple of seconds in front of Ragazzi now. Ragazzi is the last title rival standing for Mauro Kalamya. Lap then. Mauro Kalamya picking off some back markers. Oh yeah, and Ragazzi went to the inside, Simoni on the outside. Kalamya lost some of his lead there. Will Ragazzi attack? This is the battle for the championship. Ragazzi has certainly closed up on Kalamya, and it's all to do with that bang marker. The attack has to come at some point. It's all or nothing for Ragazzi, trying to delay Kalamya, claiming the title. Whoa, they're going wide here, Ragazzi and Simoni. Ragazzi going both sides, there's contact. Oh, and he's into the spin, Ragazzi. He tried too much. Into the gravel for Ragazzi. And saying stuck there, but he's going to get going again. He's lost at least one position. Well, Simoni now second. Alberto Cola on board here. And we should see Ragazzi in the gravel trap. And yeah, Cola did get up into third. So Ragazzi losing a couple of spots as he tried to gain a position and take the win. Still on the last lap, Kalamya with Simoni behind him. Simoni third all race long until Ragazzi's mishap. And Simoni went a little wide there. I don't think he's going to have any chance of getting through. This is the last corner. Well, Simoni going too wide again. Kalamia will take the race win. It's his sixth of the season. Moving inexorably closer to the 2014 championship crown. Simone second, Cola third. Ragazzi must be furious as he crosses the line in fourth behind the back marker, Marcel Pavlicek. Let's have another look then of the clash between the leading duo. That was the strongest image of the first race, Ragazzi's attack on Kalamia. A failed attack by Ragazzi. He was trying to force the issue.
I'm looking forward for the championship, and normally I want to try only take home some points, not probably the victories, but if I can win, I will try to win races, so I'm happy.
I tried all the race to don't lose the first two, and after that I try to push all I can in the last lap after Ricardo spin, but it was already the maximum for me, so congratulations to Mauro, because it was very fast and no mistake all the race, so I'm happy because second is always a good result.
Time the second race in the Maserati Trofeo Round 5, the Shanghai International Circuit. First, the best moments from race one. Kalamia with the win. There was the collision between Riccardo Ragazzi and Mauro Kalamia on the very final lap. So the main issue in race two is, will Ragazzi go for revenge on Kalamia?
Try to stay behind Mauro, and I want how is you see speed today, and I don't know if I will try to overtake him. We will see, because it's very important for the race three to don't have a lot of penalty, and we will see after the half of the race.
Ragazzi second on the grid behind Mauro Kalamia, the pole sitter. So Ragazzi trying to play it tactically, because you do get a time handicap for the endurance race if you win and you attack. Kalamia leading out of the first corner. Contacts further down the field. The spin for the number five there, Andreas Segler. Segler thrown off the racing line and into the spin. So the same leading trio, Kalamia, Ragazzi and Simone. Well, Sinigiato is actually third for now, ahead of Simone. Simone the 23, I think he's actually down in fifth. Oh well. Still the same lead duo though as the first race, with Kalamia and Ragazzi. Simone, we saw him go through. There's a problem for Tit Van Son in the 46. The Chinese driver here, Tit Van Son. Tit Van Son getting going again. Kalamia looking good in the lead. There are some attacks further down the field. Let's look at the top of the screen there. That's where the action is right now. Well, it's the 8 and 67 who keep coming together. Mark Turley, the 8. The 67, John Hureshi. Oh no, there we go. I thought they'd got through it, but now it's the 67. John Hureshi in the spin. He must have been angry, Mark Turley, with the way Hureshi was driving. I wonder if he's extracted retaliation there. Hureshi losing a lot of time and some positions, as that's the 89 going off. It's Piran Lee, one of the local drivers. I think we might need the safety car out of that, because I don't think he's going to be able to get going again, Piran Lee. This on lap 4, he's on a dangerous spot on the track. Oh, indeed, they're going to have to extract him from the barriers. That means all the gaps will be closed up with the safety car out. At these moments, everyone thinks about Jules Bianchi and what happened at the Formula One Grand Prix in Japan. As out comes the tractor on the edge of the circuit. But the safety car is out. The race has been neutralized. Let's have a look at the restart on board with Giorgio Sernaggiato. Now let's also have a look at the restart with Massimo Mantovani. I think Mantovani overtook someone there even before the restart was called. Mantovani going a bit too wide there. Very difficult the first few corners after a restart when the tyres have cooled. Last 5 minutes of the race, Calamia leading from Rigazzi, then Simone Sernaggiotti fourth, Lino Curti in fifth. Then we could see Giuseppe Fascicolo. Well, the positions are shifting around, as you can see. I think you should have a look at the picture rather than the ladder, because it's still Calamia from Rigazzi. Even though Rigazzi's being shifted about on that order on the left. The last 4 minutes of the race then. Let's keep with this to the end. Will Rigazzi go for the attack, or will Calamia make it two wins from as many races in China? Rigazzi is worried about the time handicap that he'd have in the endurance race. Should he win this one? Rigazzi with increasing thought to attacking Calamia. Wow, look how close Rigazzi is now. right in the slipstream. Calamia forced to stay on the right-hand side of the track to protect his position. Now Ragazzi starting to drift across. No room there on the inside for Ragazzi. We're getting close to contact between these two cars. It's Alan Simoni who's back up to third place now. Well, there will be two laps to go. This lap, then one more to decide the race victory in race two of the Trofeo Maserati from Shanghai. The Swiss team leading, the Italians queuing up behind Mauro Calamia. Ragazzi looking this way and that. Ragazzi trying to ensure that there is some suspense for the end of the season here. And the rain starts to fall. And that's going to complicate things still further for the drivers. Just drizzle for now. Right at the back of the field, a spin. Calamia, Ragazzi, Simoni, and then Senna Giotto. As we go into the last lap. If there's going to be an attack from Ragazzi, it has to come soon. Ragazzi showing himself. Calamia protecting the inside. Ragazzi, well, he hasn't completely protected the inside. Ragazzi trying it. Contact between the two. And Ragazzi does get through and forced Calamia wide. Calamia down to fourth. Well, the same sort of move as in race one, except this time it worked for Ragazzi. Let's have another look as we go on board with Calamia. Over to the left, and surely we'll be able to see or hear the contact between the two cars as Ragazzi comes through on the right-hand side. There we go. There was the contact. Calamia thrown off the racing line, catapulted into the grass, and losing three positions on the very final lap. Well, Ragazzi said he wasn't out for revenge, but he's going to take it here. Into the last minute. Calamia fourth. He won't improve on that. We saw a battle there between the 18 and the 7, Lino Curti. And Giuseppe Fascicolo. Well, Fascicolo put under the spotlight for overtaking while the safety car was out on the track. And he was relegated from his position. This one of Lino Curti's best displays of the season. The last corner and the win for Riccardo Ragazzi. So Calamia not crowned champion just yet. Simoni second. Senna Giotto third and Calamia fourth. Look at the celebrations for Curti in fifth.
I don't know, I was second and I thought, okay, I can try to overtake Mauro or not because we will see for the race three for that penalty. But in the last lap, I thought, okay, I have to try it because the victory is a victory. and in the first corner he was a little bit more slowly than me. I tried in the side, and so here we are.
And there is the podium from race two. Sanagiotto third, we can hear from him.
I'm very happy because I come back on the podium after 2 years. This is my second race with Trofeo Maserati for this season, and it's very hard to come back in this car because it's a very technical car, it's very fast. I'm driving in another category and it's very difficult to split from a car to another car.
The Maserati Trofeo on Motors TV, and the start of the third and final race of the weekend at Shanghai, the penultimate round of the season. And still the question, will Mauro Calamia, the number 35, the Swiss driver, become champion here? The 1 hour endurance race with an obligatory pit stop then. Calamia the pole sitter, Ragazzi second, Simone third, Calamia the race one winner, Ragazzi the winner of race two. Well, during that mandatory pit stop, there will be driver changes for those competing as a duo. On lap one, so just under an hour to go. We saw Alan Simone there in fourth place behind Giorgio Sanagiotto, who's already made up one position off the start. There's the number eight, that's Mark Turley. Things not starting well for him. Already saw him involved in incidents in race two. And a complicated weekend for Mark Turley. Andreas Segler is up there too. Segler in the number five. There's the long race, so patience required. It's also very hot in Shanghai. And anything can happen in those pit stops. The teams will play a crucial role here. The end of the first lap, Calamia leading, and he's pulled out a bit of a lead over Ragazzi. We have to stop for 20 seconds in the pit stops. Oh, something coming off the car there, and there could be a change in the leadership here. Ragazzi and Calamia. Oh, there's a little collision between those two. I don't know quite what is going on between this duo, but it's going backwards and forwards between them all weekend long. Ragazzi has gone through into first place. Well, I think it's the number eight of Mark Turley who really got in Calamia's way, and Ragazzi saw that and made the most of it. Turley coming out at just the wrong moment in front of all the leaders. Still a very long way to go in this race, though, as Ragazzi leads from Calamia. Well, time penalties for Calamia and Ragazzi because they have to stop for longer in the pits, so that could play into Simone's hands. That was Phil Bergen we caught a brief sight of in the pits, and he won't finish. Right, into the spin, Jolie here. The number 28. It was a collision with the 67 of John Hirschi there. And this is what happened with Hirschi. Got a bit carried away. And like Turley, he's had a few difficulties this weekend. Well, things have settled down at the front now. Rigazzi from Kalemia. These two inseparable all weekend long. Simone is in third, looking on. No trouble behind him. He's a bit far away, though, to start hassling the lead duo. Kalemia already 6 race wins this season. Well, Rigazzi got through, past Kalemia with the aid of a back marker. Kalemia was hoping the same would happen. Well, that back marker has just allowed Simone to come back. The front three covered by half a second or so. Incredible stuff in the final race of the weekend at Shanghai. The long straight now. Can either Simone or Kalemia get into the slipstream? Kalemia having a look. Tense out there. Simone, well positioned, coming off the last corner. Just under 32 minutes to go. 89 rather. Teng Zhiyang. Well, a lot of traffic to contend with for the lead trio. That's what happens in these longer races. Rigazzi under braking. Kalemia thinking about it. The pit window is open and Kalemia is through, but they all go through into the stands too. Oh, was Rigazzi undercutting? Well, Kalemia going in early. Kalemia has a 20-second time penalty from winning the previous day. Simone into the pits as well, but Rigazzi did stay out in the end. Very strategic. Now Simone will have the advantage over Kalemia because Kalemia's got to stop a bit longer. Rigazzi caught in traffic, so not able to really profit from those two going in early, I think. Suggest that Rigazzi might be well served by coming in soon. You see the P's there, that's all those who are in the pit stops. Senegiato coming in too. Number 16, Yanchuk Weyandi. Will Ricardo Ragazzi come in one lap behind Calamia and Simone? Well, Simone out in front of Calamia because Calamia had that extra 20 seconds standstill. Need Ragazzi to come in now to get the true positions. Ragazzi is still out there, so not coming in yet. Looks like Ragazzi is about 20 seconds clear of Calamia. He could do with a bit more than that. Well, this is Mantovani coming in, and he'll be handing over to Alberto Cola. Minutes remaining, and Ragazzi at last into the pits. He's got a 20 second time penalty too, just like Calamia, because of his race victory in race two. The last time check we had him around 20 seconds in front of Calamia. Really important this to the overall outcome, not only of this race, but also as to whether Calamia will be crowned champion. Calamia hoping to take the crown with a round in hand. Abu Dhabi still to come this season. I think Simone must have hit problems with his tyres because Calamia's got well in front of Simone now, and Calamia's trying to go as quickly as possible in order to be in front of Ragazzi when Ragazzi comes out. Calamia flat out. Into the last corner. Where's Ragazzi? Here he comes. It's going to be very tight, but I think Calamia is going to be in front of him. Indeed, Calamia in front of Ragazzi. Segler is the race leader momentarily, but the five still needs to stop. I think Senegiotto is actually in front of Ragazzi and Calamia, or Calamia and Ragazzi in that order now. Senegiotto didn't have a time penalty. Senegiotto, then Calamia, then Ragazzi. Senegiotto only had a 5 second stop, but definitely not the 15 seconds there between Senegiotto and his pursuers. They're much quicker than he is, and that suggests that Calamia should be able to get past Senegiotto. Not this time. Oh, a little wobble for Calamia. He does get through, though. Senegiotto going far too wide. So now it's Calamia leading, Senegiotto second, Ragazzi third. Should Calamia hold this position, he'll become the 2014 champion. Following on from Renaud Kerpens, the champion in 2013 and 2012, David Baldi in 2011, and Pietro Zumerli in 2010. This would be Kalamia's seventh win of the season, and he'd become the champion. Simone is in fourth, he's a long way behind Ragazzi. Ragazzi will fancy his chances of getting past Senegiotto at some point, but he's too far back from Kalamia to mount a challenge. Dear, the 67 John Hureshi hasn't had a great weekend. The abandonment there for John Hureshi. Inside the last 10 minutes of the penultimate round of the season from Shanghai. It's the number 27, Alessandro Iazzetti. Replay of some contact there between the 31 and the 60, I think. 31, Wei Zhu. The 60, Roberto Ranieri. And it's over for Ranieri. Over two for Hureshi. Now the 7 and the 18. The 18, Lino Curti, pushed there by Giuseppe Frascicolo. Back to the live racing, and Ragazzi putting the pressure on Senegiotto. As long as Kalamia goes on and takes the win, he will be champion, and look at the gap now. With time running out, even if Ragazzi gets through, he'll be hard pushed even to get on terms with Mauro Kalamia, let alone find a way past him. Ragazzi through, going wide there, Senegiotto letting him through, I think, in the end. So a change for the second place, Riccardo Ragazzi, scoring some good results this weekend. Definitely Mauro Kalamia's nearest challenger, but Kalamia in a class of his own this season, you have to say, and he will be a deserving champion. A few hundred meters between Kalamia and Ragazzi, 4 or 5 seconds at least. Minutes to hold on for Kalamia to become the champion. The last lap, a victory lap for Mauro Kalamia, the Swiss driver. He is going to become the 2014 champion. A reminder that Renault Kuppens was champion in 2012 and 2013. He's going to be succeeded by Mauro Kalamia. This will be race win number 7 of the season. His second win of the weekend in China. A winner in race 1. Race 2 didn't go as well for Mauro Kalamia as he finished 4th. Barged out of it by Riccardo Ragazzi. Great work from the Swiss team of Mauro Kalamia. It's not Kalamia's favourite circuit, but he's going to get the two wins. Another fine meeting for him. Calamio was in the championship lead from the Hungaro ring the second round of the season and never relinquished it. Senator Giotto on for a second podium finish in a row, a second third place in a row. The straight for Calamia, and then the final corner, the checkered flag, the race win, and the 2014 Maserati Trofeo champion is Mauro Calamia. Riccardo Ragazzi crossing the line in second. Giorgio Senigiato in third. Alan Simoni fourth. Pascacolo crossing the line in fifth, but I think the race direction penalising him. And he'll end up ninth, actually, with Segler promoted to fifth.
Happy with the last victory. But it was a really hard race because it was so hot in the car. But I think also, thanks for that I do a lot of training at home for my own physique. So yeah, I think as a teamwork we do, and we won the last race here in Shanghai.
So Calamia keeping his cool in the searing Shanghai heat, winning two races out of three in China and becoming the 2014 champion. We'll leave you with highlights from race three. Of course, we will bring you the final round of the season from Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates. Congratulations once again to Mauro Calamia. And thanks for watching all season long on Motors TV this Maserati Trofeo.